ईश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः ओम डियर फ्रेंड्स द लास्ट क्लास वी रेड दिस वर्स नंबर 4 न कर्माणामनारम्भात् नैष्कर्म्यं पुरुषोश्नुते न च सन्न्यसनादेव सिद्धिं समधिगच्छति सो कृष्णा टोल्ड दैट ए पर्सन डज नॉट अटेन दैट स्टेट ऑफ एक्शनलेसनेस बाय नॉट कमेंसिंग एक्शंस एंड इन द सेकंड लाइन ही आल्सो सेड दैट बाय मेयरली रिनाउंसिंग ऑल एक्शंस बाय मेयरली रिनाउंसिंग एक्शंस ही विल नॉट अटेन दैट सिद्धि सिद्धि अगेन इज द सेम एज नैष्कर्म्यम सो दैट इज वॉट ही सेड एंड ही इज गोइंग टू एलैबोरेट सो द नेक्स्ट वर्स रीड्स लाइक दिस नहि कश्चित् क्षणमपि जातु तिष्ठत्यकर्मकृत् नहि कश्चित् क्षणमपि जातु तिष्ठत्यकर्मकृत् कार्यते ह्यवशः कर्म सर्वः प्रकृतिजैर्गुणैः कार्यते ह्यवशः कर्म सर्वः प्रकृतिजैर्गुणैः सो वी विल फॉलो द सेम फार्मूला ऑफ स्प्लिटिंग दिस वर्ड्स न हि कश्चित् क्षणम प्लस अपि क्षणम अपि जातु तिष्ठति प्लस अकर्मकृत तिष्ठत्यकर्मकृत दैट इज संधि संधि मीन्स ए सॉर्ट ऑफ यूफोनिक कॉम्बिनेशन तिष्ठत्यकर्मकृत कार्यते ह्यवशः इज स्प्लिट एज हि प्लस अवशः हि अवशः कर्म सर्वः प्रकृतिजैहि गुणैहि बिकम्स प्रकृतिजैर्गुणैहि सो लेट अस ट्राई टू आइडेंटिफाई द वर्ब्स एंड देन कनेक्ट द वर्ब विद द अदर वर्ड्स सो हियर न हि कश्चित् क्षणम् अपि जातु तिष्ठति अकर्मकृत् दिस इज वन लाइन सो इन दिस लाइन तिष्ठति इज द वर्ब तिष्ठति मीन्स स्टेस तिष्ठ ष्ठ दिस ठ इज द सेम एज इंग्लिश स्टे धातु इज अगेन ष्ठ धातु हियर इज ष्ठ धातु इट बिकम्स तिष्ठति इज द सेम एज इंग्लिश स्टे नो वन स्टेस न तिष्ठति दिस न इज देर न तिष्ठति नो वन स्टेस नो वन वेर इज दट वन कश्चित् दट कश्चित् नो वन स्टेस न कश्चित् तिष्ठति कश्चित् मीन्स एनी वन न कश्चित् मीन्स नो वन तिष्ठति स्टेस वॉट स्टेस हौ क्षणमपि ईवन फॉर ए मिनिट ईवन फॉर ए मोमेंट क्षणम अपि क्षणम मीन्स ए स्मॉल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ टाइम ए स्मॉल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ टाइम क्षणम अपि अपि मीन्स ईवन ईवन फॉर ए स्मॉल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ टाइम स्टेस स्टेस इन वॉट मैनर तिष्ठति अकर्मकृत अकर्मकृत मीन्स वन हू डज नॉट डू एनी एक्शन इज कॉल्ड अकर्मकृत कर्मकृत मीन्स वन हू डज एक्शन इज कर्मकृत अकर्मकृत मीन्स समबडी हू डज नॉट डू एनी एक्शन सो हियर द अन्वय टोटल अन्वय विल बी लाइक दिस न कश्चित् नो वन न कश्चित् मीन्स नो वन न इज नो कश्चित् मीन्स एनी वन बोथ वेन कंबाइन नो वन नो वन क्षणमपि मीन्स ईवन फॉर अ मिनिट सो इन बिटवीन देर इज वन ही इन फैक्ट दट ही वी कैन नंबर इट एज नंबर वन सो दट ही यू कैन गिव इट एज नंबर वन ही मीन्स बिकॉज दट कनेक्ट्स विद द अर्लियर श्लोक इन द अर्लियर श्लोक ही सेड न सन्यासनादेव सिद्धिम समाधि गच्छति वाई बिकॉज सो दट इज द कनेक्शन बिकॉज न कश्चित् नोबडी जातु जातु मीन्स एवर जातु मीन्स एवर न जातु मीन्स नेवर न कश्चित् जातु मीन्स नेवर नेवर एनी वन सो दट ऑल्सो न कैन बी कनेक्टेड विथ कश्चित् न कैन बी कनेक्टेड विथ जातु दट इज न जातु मीन्स नेवर तिष्ठति अकर्मकृत तिष्ठति स्टेस अकर्मकृत मीन्स बाय नॉट डूइंग एनी एक्शन So that means everyone does action, he doesn't stay idle for any minute. So you may say, okay, I am staying idle, but staying idle also is an action. So that of course we'll see. Karma, staying idle also, that is again an action. So karyate hi avashaha karma. So the second line again, it is an independent line. He, again there is one he. He means because, yasmat, because. Why? Sarvaha. Sarvaha means everyone. Everyone. Prakruti jaihi gunaihi. So thus we can either start with prakruti jaihi gunaihi or with sarvaha. सर्वह मीन्स एवरी वन प्रकृतिजैः गुणैः मीन्स बै द गुणास विच आर ओरिजिनेटेड फ्रॉम द प्रकृति आई विल एक्सप्लेन दिस थिंग फ्रॉम द बै द गुणास प्रकृतिजैः गुणैः गुणैः इज इन तृतीय बहुवचनम तृतीय यू नो इंस्ट्रुमेंटल केस प्लूरल इंस्ट्रुमेंटल केस नॉमिनेटिव केस ऑब्जेक्टिव केस से इंस्ट्रुमेंटल केस डेटिव केस सो दैट इज हाउ दैट विभक्ति गोस ऑन सो दिस इज इन तृतीय विभक्ति इन अदर वर्ड्स इंस्ट्रुमेंटल केस एंड ऑल्सो प्लूरल प्रकृतिजैः गुणैः मीन्स देर आर सर्टन थिंग्स कॉल्ड गुणास बॉर्न ऑफ दिस प्रकृति वाट इज दट प्रकृति वाट आर दोस गुणास आई विल एक्सप्लेन प्रकृतिजैः गुणैः सर्वः एवरी वन कार्यते कार्यते मीन्स ही इज मेड टू डू कार्यते इज मेड टू डू इट इज अगेन इट इज कॉल्ड कर्मणि प्रयोग आर अ पैसिव वॉइस वी नो दट इन इंग्लिश देर इज वाट इज कॉल्ड एन ऐक्टिव वॉइस एंड अ पैसिव वॉइस सो दिस इज कार्यते इज कर्मणि प्रयोग ही इज मेड टू डू एंड इन वॉट वे ही इज मेड टू डू अवशः ही प्लस अवशः अवशः मीन्स इन अ रादर हेल्पलेस मैनर यू सी यू आर यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू डू ए थिंग But still, there is a nature which is propelling you, which is impelling you to do some action. So even if you don't want to do or even if you do not consciously decide to do a thing, your nature is pushing you in that direction. So that is what is avashaha. Avashaha means in a rather helpless way. Avashaha. Vasham means control. Avashaha means he has no control on himself. He is under the control of the gunas. So that is the meaning. So avashaha karma sarvaha prakrutijaihi gunaihi. So here again, of course, we have to explain. I will explain whether everybody is pushed like this or only then if everybody is pushed like this, where is the need for Gita Shastra? Where is the need for Krishna to tell about all this? So Krishna is ultimately going to say that these gunas are something which is they are trying to control you. Come out of the fold of these three gunas. That is the message of Gita. Come out of the fold of these three gunas, you shake off. You are an independent man. You are not bound to do a thing. You are an independent man. You are independent to discover yourself. So that is what is Krishna's message. So Nistrai Gunyo Bhavarjuna. That sloka also we are going to see in the same chapter. Though gunas are there, you are supposed to shake off. You are supposed to shake off the bonds of nature and realize your nature. This nature will lead you to some attractive objects outside. You either want this, you want this, that, you see an object, you want it, you see something else, you like it, you see some other object, you hate it. So all these things like love, hate, desire and all these things, these are all prakrutijai gunaihi. Prakrutijaha gunaha. Taihi becomes prakrutijaihi gunaihi. So a man is driven, a person is driven into action. Every minute he is driven into action. He goes out, he goes into, he sees a mall and then there are so many desirable things there. So all these things, the whole world is something like a huge mall where you see so many things outside and then everything you want. So that is the thing. So let us come to the shloka. So the first line, the order is he, because na kashit, no one, kshanamapi, even for a minute, tishthati akarmakrut, stays without doing any action. Because, again, he, because sarvaha, everyone, Prakrutijaihi gunaihi. Either that you can put that one on Prakrutijaihi gunaihi or Sarvaha. You are showing that shloka?
Yes.
Okay. Sarvaha, everyone. The avashaha karma karyate. Avashaha means in a rather helpless way. Karma action karyate. He is made to do. He is made to do karma. So impelled by these things called gunas, a normal person. Sarvaha refers to a normal person and not to a jnani. Because jnani is not one who is not bound, he is one who is not bound by these gunas. Jnani comes out of the fold of these gunas. So this sarva refers to an ordinary man who has not realized his self. So that it is at that stage. So let us see what are the significant words here which say technical words. We can call them technical words in Vedanta. So what are the technical words? The first line, there is no technical word. Na hi kashit chanamapi jatu tishthati akarmakrutu. There is no technical word. Karma is one technical word. We have known the meaning already. Then karyate hi avashaha karma sarvaha prakruti jaihi gunaihi. So these two words are new. Prakruti is one word. Guna is another word which are new to a student of Vedanta or student of Gita. So what is this prakruti? I was saying about the supreme reality. How the supreme reality is defined in Vedanta? The supreme reality, which we loosely call God, is of the nature of a pure consciousness, which is existing all around. Sat, sat means existing. Jna, jnanam means consciousness. Satyam, jnanam, anantam. Anantam means infinite. Infinite means that is something which is pervading the whole cosmos, beyond cosmos. You see, you go to any number of, say, galaxies and all that, pervading the whole thing. There is nothing else apart from this consciousness. So that is what it says. And that consciousness is appearing as this whole cosmos. So that is our theory. And in this cosmos, we are in a small little bit, tiny speck called the world. And we are trying to speculate about how I know the real God, and somebody says, I know the real God, and then we are fighting. So that is the problem. So, prakriti jaihi gunaihi. So in that, from that consciousness, there is an ability to manifest. I think I told in the last class, I told that there is an ability in this, this consciousness has a power of manifesting. So that power of manifesting is called prakriti, prakriti, prakarshena karoti. That is prakriti. The meaning of prakriti means pra again is one, kru is the same as create. Prakriti, prakarshena creates, it shows itself in diverse fashions. Karoti, there is another word for prakriti is maya, another word is called avyakruta. Okay, we'll see that when we come across those words. Then guna. Guna is another technical word. So this whole prakriti, that manifesting ability, in what manner does it manifest? So our ancients, our forefathers, our people who envisaged these Upanishads and all these things, who had vision of these Upanishads. So they have observed what all things which are there in the cosmos. So in this whole creation, whatever you see, it is having some characteristic. In human beings, let us say, in human beings, if you take, there are some people who are calm, quiet, contented, who are devoted to knowledge, who are devoted to studies, very truthful, very straightforward. So that is one type. There is another type who are good, no doubt, but then who are very aggressive, who want to dominate others, who want to possess things, who want to acquire things. So that is one, another type. There is another type which is lazy, totally lacking in initiative, something which is dull, something which is sleepy in nature, sleepish, sheepish. So that sort of type is another thing. Even food, suppose you take some food, certain foods, they give some peace of mind, they integrate with the body, they give you some peace of mind, they make your mind calm, and then they don't excite you. They are quiet, they don't excite the stomach, they neither harm you, they go to the strengthening of the body-mind complex. So there are certain foods which are called, are there. There are some other foods which excite a person. There are some other foods which dull. Suppose you take some LSD or some drink or some morphine or something like that, they are there to dull the mind. So that sort of thing. So in everything, practically everything in the universe can be characterized into these categories. So that is how our, say, ancients who have observed the nature, they said all those things which are characterized by that, features like contentment, happiness, though he is not very rich, he is happy. He need not be very rich, he is happy. He is having that ability to pursue knowledge, he is having that clear thinking, and he is a straightforward man, honest, mentally honest. So all this mental honesty, which is called shaucham. Shaucha, there are two types of shaucha, we say. We use the word shaucham. Shuchi. Shuchi means cleanliness. This cleanliness is of two types, mental shaucha and physical shaucha. So this shaucham, so all these gunas put together, all these characteristics are put together, they are called sattva. Sattva. S-A-T-T-V-A, you can note it as sattva. Then the other type which we saw, that is aggressiveness, possessiveness, one wants to acquire something more, one wants to dominate others. So the domineering, tendency, and also to acquire, greed, even this greed also. All these things, it is called rajoguna. Sattva, rajas. The third type, that is sleepy, sheepish type, and also total lack of initiative, and sometimes violent also. So all those things, and also sticking on to one particular notion and then thinking that it itself is ultimate. So that we are going to see in 16th chapter. If we see that Gunatraya Vibhaga Yoga, if you see that 16th chapter, there Lord Krishna explains all these things in a much more elaborate way. So that is one nature, that is called tamas. Tamas literally means darkness. Sattva is one, rajas is one, tamas is one. So everything is in the universe is characterized by these three qualities. You can distinguish them into these three types. So these three are supposed to be the constituents in that prakriti. They are called the constituents. They are not physical constituents like chemical compounds. The chemical some chemicals which go, which mix and then which make a compound. It is not like that. This is something which is ethereal, we can say. It is something which are imperceivable, which cannot be perceived as some objects. Guna, it is not as though you have taken some chawal, dal, and then you have mixed with something else and made some pudding or something like that. It is not like that. So prakriti is not something like a pudding made of so many things. For the sake of convenience and for the sake of understanding, these people, our rishis have divided or have analyzed the human nature and then the nature of all things which are there in the universe, and then they said they all fall into three types. These three types are called three guna. The English word translation for guna can be, actually sometimes we translate it as characteristic. Sometimes this guna is used in the, it is never translated. There are certain you cannot translate certain words because there is no equivalent in English language. There is no equivalent in the other culture. So that is why we don't translate certain words. So, but for the sake of explaining, we have to use some words. So some guna actually means some characteristics. It is also translated as some modes, types. So these three types, sattva is one type, rajas is another type, tamas is another type. So these three things, they impact a person. So you find somebody whose dominant nature is sattva. Another person whose dominant nature is rajas. Another person whose dominant nature is tamas. So in this rajas there are again two types. One person who wants to dominate all other people physically. There is another person who wants to grab all money of others, who wants to grab more money. So that is acquisitiveness in terms of money. You can compare it with some multinational. And then this rajas, dominating others, you can compare it with some sort of imperialistic attitude. So you want to possess, you want to take control of everybody, dominate the whole world, that is imperialism, isn't it? So this rajas has two branches, that is one is imperialism combined with multinational approach. So that is what is rajas. Sattva guna is being contented, happy, cool, not getting perturbed. You may be beaten by somebody, getting beaten by somebody, but still you are cool. Tamo guna is another thing, some foolhardy approach to things, and then just sticking on to something and then that considering that as the ultimate. So in fact we have to see 16th chapter also for that, to understand what is this sattva, rajas and tamas. So these are called gunas. So here I think we will stop this shloka. Next shloka, what is time left? 11 minutes. Then we will start the next shloka. We will start the next shloka also. The next shloka is like this. Nahi kaschit kshanamapi, after that. The next shloka is, Krishna says, okay, we are having we are now talking about sannyasa. I explained it in an earlier class. And then the gunas, they keep on impelling. So suppose somebody tries to come out of the control of these three gunas and wants to forcibly control himself. So what will he do? He will forcibly sit and then he will try to forcibly control his sense organs. So that is the situation which Krishna is describing in the next shloka. So the next shloka reads, Karmendriyani samyamya ya aste manasa smaran indriyarthan vimudhatma mithyacharasa uchyate. Karmendriyani samyamya. So this samyamya is actually pronounced as sanyamya. by, in fact, the people who actually traditional way of pronouncing or the most correct way of pronouncing is Sanyamya. Because there is no such pronunciation in English, or because we have to also denote that makara, we sometimes call it Samyamya, but the strict way is Sanyamya. Karmendriyani Sanyamya ya aste manasa smaran indriyarthan vimudhatma mithyacharasa uchyate. The meaning is, one who forcibly controls this, say this five sense organs, we know we have got five sense organs, eye, nose, say the sense of touch, the sense of taste, so all these things, the sense of smell, all these are five sense organs. You forcibly control. But then in your mind, you are thinking about that, I have given up this rasagulla, I have given up ice cream, I have given up pizza. You keep on thinking about that and lamenting over that. So that is the situation in the first line. Then that person, though he is outwardly appearing to be a highly, say, pious, saintly man, he is always thinking of those things. A man may go to an ashram and keep on thinking about all worldly things. So that sort of thing. So first you have to educate your mind. It is not a question of physically controlling. First of all, you have to educate your mind. That is the basic problem. So here let us see the shloka. Karmendriyani. That is your, if you want to break it, karma plus indriyani. Karmendriyani. Sanyamya. It does not break. Ya. Aste. Manasa. Break, smaran, indriyarthan. You need not break it because indriyartha is a samasa. Indriya, indriyanam, arthaha, indriyarthaha. Artha means object. Indriya is sense, sense organ. Indriyarthaha means objects which relate to the sense organ. Suppose my eye is there. In front of me there is a tree. Eye is the sense organ. The tree is the sense object. So that is the indriyartha. Suppose I see some other rasagulla or something, some ice cream or pizza in front of me. So that becomes an indriyartha for my eyes, for my tongue, for my nose. All these three indriyas, they are pouncing on that. So rasagulla or pizza has got its special features. Then indriyarthan, that is called indriyartha. The object for an indriya is called indriyartha. Artha means object. Then vimudha plus atma, vimudhatma. That is again a samasa. Vimudha plus atma. Samasa, you know. Samasa means a combination of two words is becoming one word. Samasa is one word. But it is a combination of two different words. Vimudha plus atma becomes vimudhatma. That is one who is deluded. Vimudhatma. Mithyacharaha. Again it is a samasa. Mithya plus acharaha, mithyacharaha. That is one who is a hypocritical nature. One who is achara. One whose behavior is all false. False behavior. Mithyachara literally means, mithya means false, achara means behavior or conduct. Mithyachara means one with false conduct. That is a hypocrite. The total word means a hypocrite. Mithyachara sa uchyate. So if you see the first line here, how do you connect these words? What is the verb here? Yaha aste. Aste means who stays, who sits. Asa dhatu, it is not even asa, asa dhatu. Asa means to sit. It is a funny word. Asa upaveshane. Asa upaveshane. Upaveshane means sitting. Then this word you come across in upasana. We know the word upasana. Upa plus asana. Upasana. Upaste. Aste. Asate. Asate. Asate is plural. Upasate means people worship. Upasate means, upasate is not singular, upasate is plural, upaste is singular, upaste is singular, upasate is plural. So asate, aste is singular here. Who stays? Manasa smaran. Who say this verb is aste. Then yaha aste, the one who sits. How? Karmendriyani samyamya. Having samyamya means having controlled. Yama dhatu. Yama means to control, to restrain. Having restrained what? Karmendriyani, karma plus indriyani, karmendriyani, that is organs of action. There are two types of indriyas. Indriya means the sense, the organs which move towards the objects. So there are organs, sense organs which perceive. There are some other organs which go and grab, isn't it? The organs which go and grab, they are called karmendriyani. That is organs of action. sense organs are those who feel the smell, who look at it, who say they are called the sense organs. So sense organ is Jnanendriya. Karmendriya is the actual organs which go and actually enjoy those things. So Karmendriyani Sanyamya, one who has forcibly controlled or restrained this Karmendriyani, and then he aste manasas maran aste, he keeps on, he stays remembering them, recalling them, doting on them. That is that manasas maran, he is doting on them. Manasas maran, smaran means recalling, smriti, smriti means recalling. Manasa, smaran, gachan, piban, these are all shatrantha words. They are called shatrantha, we need not go into grammar. Piban, drinking, piban aste, he is sitting drinking. Then gachan aste, he is going. It is a present continuous. This smaran, gachan, piban, shwasan, all these things relate to present continuous. Manasa, smaran aste, that means he keeps on remembering them. So that is the word manasa, smaran aste. So then, yaha, karmendriya, you see the word order, yaha, sanyamya, what sanyamya? Indriyani, karmendriyani sanyamya, yaha, karmendriyani sanyamya, manasa smaran aste. He keeps on thinking about certain things. What are they? It comes to second line. Indriyarthan smaran aste. Then, the next, see, saha, the sa is there, saha is the second line, saha, vimudhatma means such deluded person, a person really deluded, a person with a deluded thinking, mithyacharaha uchyate, mithyacharaha means a person of false conduct, false behavior, mithya is false, achara is behavior or conduct, a person of false conduct means a hypocrite. Outwardly he is something, inwardly he is something else. So he is called Mithyacharaha. So Uchyate, Uchyate means he is told, he is called like that. He is called means called by whom? Called by Loka, called by people. Called by people as a Mithya, Mithyachara. The verb in Uchyate is Vach, Vachadhatu, Vachaparibhashane. Vachaparibhashane means he is Vakti, Vakti, Vakta, you know the word Vakta. Vakta means an orator, a speaker. So then Karmani Prayoga, that is passive voice, it becomes Uchyate, he is called Uchyate, he is called Mithyachara Uchyate. So the overall connection is like this, Yaha, the one who Karmendriyani Sanyamya, that is having controlled all these external organs. External organs means organs of action, that is hand, foot, etc., they are called the organs of action. Having controlled them, but then manasa smaran aste, having controlled what? Having controlled karmendriyani, manasa smaran aste, manasa smaran, that is keep on remembering. Remembering what? Indriyarthan. Indriyarthan manasa smaran aste. Aste indriyarthan manasa smaran. Connect to you in whatever manner you want. Indriyarthan, all these sense objects, he keeps on recalling, doting on them internally, doting on them mentally. So that is mentally doting on them, you are controlling the sense, or you are controlling the external organs or organs of action. So such a person, saha, saha means such a person, mithyacha, vimudhatma, he can only be called a deluded person, mithyacharaha, that is a person of false conduct, uchyate, he is called. So here this is a significant word, Vedanta, in terms of Vedanta, significant word is this yama, sanyamya, that is a lep pratyaya, that is first class also, we see the first sloka we say, we got to that sloka, what is that word, nishchitya, tadekam vada nishchitya, nishchitya, having decided, so sanyamya, having controlled, having restrained, so that is that sanyamya. So this comes from the word, from the root yama. Yama means to restrain. You know the law, we know the Lord Yama. Lord Yama is one who restrains everybody. One who controls, one who restrains, that is called Yama. And if you know Patanjali's Yoga Sutra, there is what is called Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dhyana, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi. So that Ashtanga, it is said. In that Ashtanga, that is 8-limbed process or 8-level or 8 steps in the same ladder, the Yama is the first step. Yama is something which is the first step. Why? because though say you feel like say going after certain things, you have got a better sense, your mind can control. Your mind will say, no, this is bad. It is like a parent controlling the child. A parent says, no, you do not do this. So the parent tells the child. So my mind is something like that. Mind tells no, because the mind has already done some analysis. It has made some analysis of what is good and what is bad. So it tells what to do and what not to do. So that is why it says, no, do not do. So that karmendriya is something like a child. It is like, they say, manas is like the parent. So this manas controls yamayati. Yamayati means it controls. So this yama is that bahyendriya nigraha, that is forcibly or controlling, restraining all these external organs or the sense organs of action, that is called yama. In other words, it is also sometimes called dama. Dama means bahyendriya nigraha dama. There is a technical word, dama. So this indriyartha, that is also a word, indriya, indriyanam arthaha. Artha means object, indriya is sense organ. So indriyartha means the object which is perceived by the sense organ, which is desired or hated. In every, with every object, there is what is called love or hate, which is associated. I see, I look at a thing, I like it. I look at something else, I don't like it. So that is love and hate, they are again connected with this, our impressions about that object, our experience with that object. So these indriyarthas, so there are all these indriyarthas, this vimood atma keeps on thinking. Mithyacharaha, there is no technical word here. So these two words are samyamana and indriyartha. These are two technical words. So we will take up the next shloka in the next class. Thank you.